Hey everyone, and welcome to Firmly Planted Wellness Live. I am so excited that you're here for yet another episode because each and every week, my intention is to come to you with an amazing woman that is serving women in some way to help you live better. So today's guest is, you know, amazing. She's going to give us some great tips, some things that I know have been on my mind lately, especially with all the things going on around us. So I know you're going to love hearing from her. But in case you and I have not met yet, my name is Lissa Biggins, and my mission is to help women prioritize their wellness with a simple plan, right? Oftentimes we're serving everyone else and we forget to take care of us. And so by looking our best, feeling our best, we can actually give our best to the things and people that are most important to us. And today I have Amy Friederich with me. So hi, Amy. Welcome.
Hi, Lissa. Thanks for having me.
Oh my goodness. Of course. I love what you're about. So what I want to do real quick is just read a little bio so you guys have some background on Amy and just kind of where she's coming from. And then we're going to hear from her. Okay. So Amy is a 200-hour certified yoga instructor, and she is also a licensed attorney based in the St. Louis, Missouri area. She's been teaching yoga for over 4 years and also working full-time in the legal field. So I could see how maybe you needed the yoga to do the legal stuff until COVID hit, right? And then she was let go from her cushy corporate job. I'm sure a lot of you can relate right now. Seeing an immediate need for online wellness options, she wasted no time starting her business, Amy Lynn Yoga LLC. So Amy specializes in virtual yoga and wellness webinars for private and corporate clients. And Amy's on a mission to help other busy professionals improve their physical, mental, and emotional well-being. And we're going to get to hear from her. So Amy, thank you for being with us. Tell me in your words, how do you serve women and help them live well?
Sure. Well, thanks again for having me here. And, you know, my mission was really to take all of the lessons that I learned from being a practicing attorney, from working at a Fortune 500 company, being an adjunct instructor. I also teach at a community college. So, you know, I was doing a lot of things. Right. And then being a yoga teacher, and then seeing how I could take all of that experience and then share the lessons that I learned along the way in terms of finding self-care and finding work-life balance.
So would you say that you had, that was a challenge for you to find the work-life balance yourself?
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, you know, I think that's something that is challenging for anyone who works full time, to balance career and life. So
it is, it is. And, you know, right now we have this, just a whole nother layers of all these other factors that come in. Right. And so things, you know, look very different because of all of that. But what was it about yoga that drew you into that? Because there's so many different, you know, ways to add health and to take care of ourselves. What was it that really intrigued you about yoga, and how did that make a difference for you?
Sure. So for me, I've been doing yoga since college, but it was really in law school that I realized how much I needed that time, those 2 or 3 days a week that I went to yoga class with my best friend from law school. We really held each other accountable to say, you know, we're going to yoga.
Right.
And that really helped us get through school, not just because we were exercising, but just learning tips on how to manage stress and about self-care. And then getting out of law school and practicing law, you know, as a lawyer, it's not just a job you can clock in and out of. It's, you're sort of always on. It becomes part of your identity. Right. And I really wanted to have that time outside of work where I felt like I could really connect with who I was as a person, not just a lawyer.
Mm. I love that, because, you know, it probably made you a better lawyer because you actually were more in tune with who you were. You know, do you find that women in the workforce now are just overwhelmed, frustrated, burned out, and they just try to keep going and wonder why they're not doing their job or their family life as well as they want to?
Yeah, I don't want to jump too far ahead, but just one of the tips I usually give to professionals is to find something you're passionate about outside of the workplace, because we are often so identified with what we do as our career, and sort of lose sight of just who we are as human beings. And so, you know, finding something that you enjoy outside of just completely unrelated to what you do for work, you know, I think goes a long way, and just keeping that connectedness to yourself.
I love that. And it can be different for everyone, and it can change in different phases of our life as well. So that leads me to my next question is, you know, what are some tips that you have? Because right now we have some people who are working at home, some people who are working from home, some people who are still working in the office, some people who their full-time job is keeping their kids on track with their homeschool. So, you know, that's still working in its own way as well. So what are some tips that you have to share today that we can start implementing to help us in this area?
Sure. So I'll start with a few broad takeaways, if you will, and then get into some more specific tips. But so my rule number one when it comes to self-care is to just go easy on yourself, be kind to yourself. Again, this should be, we should all remind ourselves that this is a situation we've never been through before. And so, as you mentioned, Lissa, you know, everybody's in a unique situation. So not trying to compare ourselves to others, but just going, okay, well, this is the best that I can do, and knowing that that's enough. And again, just be gentle with yourself. So that's number one. And then my second takeaway would be to practice a form of self-care every single day, even if it's just 5 minutes a day. And I'll give specific examples of this, but
why do you think it's important to do something every day? Even if, I mean, you talked about going to yoga, you know, like 2 to 3 times a week with your friends. So on those other days, why do you find that's important?
Because if we don't take care of ourselves first, then how can we take care of other people? Whether that's your kids, your significant other, your clients, right? Your coworkers. If you're not starting from within and being kind to yourself and taking care of yourself, then you can't do that for other people. So you really need to be doing something every single day, even if it's small.
Right. That's so true. And I think sometimes we think it has to be this big thing. I'm going to a class, I'm going to the gym, I'm going to spend 30 minutes. But I like how you said, even if it's just 5 minutes, and I'm a big proponent of what's called health snacks, even if it's just a 5 minute break to get outside and quick do something, or, you know, get that breath of fresh air, or get, you know, take a walk around or stretch, whatever, that makes a big difference in your day. Even if you can't get a full workout in like you might like to. So that's
exactly
great. I love that.
Yeah. And those are some of the tips that I share, right? Is having a healthy snack, eating it mindfully. So really enjoying what you're eating, not just mindlessly snacking at the computer, you know, getting outside. So those are some of the tips. So I can jump into.
Do you find that, you know, when we're from at home, I mean, the refrigerator is just right over there, right? You know, I don't have to walk very far to get there. So it's a lot easier for me just to default to the things that are there. The other thing that I'm finding, and I'm just curious if you're finding this as well as you're working with clients, is because I'm spending more time, you know, connecting with people virtually, and I'm not out and about in my day like I used to be, I'm just not as active. I'm sitting a lot more. I'm feeling the stress like on my shoulders, my neck, you know, and I'm just not, you know, I don't have a way to, I don't track my steps. I don't have an Apple Watch, but I know my steps are way, way less than they normally would be. So are you seeing that and the effects of that on people?
Sure. So a couple tips for that would be for you. So you mentioned having the fridge, you know, all the food is very accessible. I would say choose a designated workspace in the house so that I maybe don't work at the kitchen table. If you can, you know, go into a guest room or an office space or just somewhere that's your designated workspace, because then you're not distracted by things like walking to the fridge and eating or trying to get chores done around the house. And then at the end of the workday, you can leave work at work. So just, you know, leave that designated workspace.
I love that.
Yeah. And then as far as making sure that you're moving throughout the day, even if you don't have an Apple Watch or Fitbit, set an alarm on your cell phone or your Outlook calendar, whatever you use, for every hour or 2 hours that just says, you know, get up or walk and go take a little walk.
Yeah, I love that. Just that reminder, we need that. In fact, I told my husband, okay, at 10:30, we're going for a walk. So I showed up at 10:30 this morning. He's like, what are you doing? I'm like, we're going for a walk. He was like, oh yeah. But it didn't mean me having to like stop what I was doing, right? Because I think sometimes it's easy to keep going. That's, I think, the challenge being working at home is that we can always be working. So I love that you're prioritizing. Are there any other tips that you want to share?
Yeah, one of my other bigger takeaways was just to set boundaries with your coworkers, your boss, even your significant other, so that there's not this expectation, whether you're working from home or you work in an office, that you will always be on and be responding to a text or an email immediately. I think we get really wrapped up in that. We've created a sense of urgency that's not really there. Most of what we're responding to does not require an immediate response. And so setting the expectation so that your coworkers or clients, whoever needs to know that you're not going to always respond immediately, or that you're after a certain point in the day when work is done, that, you know, not to expect a response from you until the next day during normal work hours.
Yes. Because it's so easy with devices that are, you know, they're attached to our wrist or something that's in our hand or our pocket all day long to continually be checking and to be responding. And then we're not fully present with ourselves. We're not fully present with our families, and we're not fully able to rest, right? Because we're still in that working mode and in that moving mode. So I absolutely love that. I don't want to cut you off. Are there any other ones you want to share before I go on to our last question?
Just along the same lines of setting boundaries and expectations, learning to say no to things that don't serve you, whether that's in the workplace or at home, and just knowing that people understand and it will be okay. And especially if you're a people pleaser and want to say yes, to just know that, you know, people understand and usually won't be upset. And so it's okay to say no to things that just aren't right for you, or that you just don't have time for. And just, again, making sure that you are the priority so that you can better take care of yourself. And
I love that. Yeah, I love that. I have a book on my bookshelf that's called The Best Yes by Lisa Turkhurst. And she talks in there about, you know, just being able to give your best yes to someone. And in order to do that, sometimes we have to say no to things that would not be our best yes, right? That we wouldn't be able to fully follow through or be able to give our best to that person, whether it's a family member or someone who's asking something of us. So I love the fact that you're making this really holistic, you know, like it's not just about what's the yoga move I should do, right? Or the breathing technique that I should do, but it's really a lot too in the mindset and how we are approaching these things that are in front of us. So just real quick, and maybe this is putting me on the spot, I don't know, but like, okay, so I'm sitting at my desk and I'm feeling, you know, like the tension, I'm feeling a little bit of the strain in the neck or things like that. So from your yoga experience, you know, what might be something I could do or that our listeners could do that's going to help relieve that and add a little quick self-care in there for them?
Sure. I can definitely show you some moves, but I do want to point out, since you asked, I'm actually sitting in front of a yoga block. Yeah, you can buy these at like Five Below for $5 or cheaper, or any local yoga studio, but it's a foam block and I put it right behind me at the small of my back, because what it does is it gives me a backrest, but also keeps me lifted so that I'm not hunching and typing, but I'm more open. And then that way I don't, at the end of the day, I don't feel as much tension up here.
And I love so that. You have that like between your back and the back of the chair.
Yeah, it's between my back and the back of my chair. And I could probably show you, but yeah, I just set it right there. And then that's my, like, it's very comfortable, but I'm still sitting up tall and I'm still avoiding hunching over. So
yeah, that's fantastic. I know I have an exercise ball that sometimes finds its way into my office that my daughter will sit on when she's working on her schoolwork next to me at my desk. Is that something that can be helpful, you know, to be engaging the core and things like that as well?
Absolutely. That's just another good way to practice good posture, because you can't really sit back or slouch on an exercise ball.
You're going to be off screen for sure. Well, Amy, you have shared some amazing tips with us. You know, I know this is something that's really important at all times, but especially with what's going on in our workplace situations, our home situations, something that I think we need to be prioritizing even more so because of all of that. So if someone wanted to connect with you, I know you've got some things you wanted to offer, you know, tell us a little bit about that. And then how can someone connect with you to learn more, get some more tips and be able to possibly work with you?
Sure. So you asked about, you know, some things you can do to relieve any tension. I actually created a yoga video that shows your listeners how to find movement throughout the day from their desk or from their chair. It's not even 15 minutes long. So if someone wants that video, they can email me. My email address is amy@amylinyogastl.com.
Perfect. And I'll have you put that down in the comments of this video after we're done. So don't worry, you guys, if you're driving right now or doing something else, I'll put it there for you.
Perfect. So you can email me. I'll send you over that video. And then my website is amylinyogastl.com. And I wanted to also just extend a discount code for your listeners too, or anyone who's watched this video, for a 25% discount off of a private session with me. And that code is ALY for Amy Lynn Yoga and 924 for September 24th.
So it does pay to listen till the end because you get all the goodies. Right? So. I hope that you're here until the end. And again, I'll have you post those down in the comments below so that people, you guys can just link to them. My freebie that I'm giving away this month is the Booster Energy Guide, because I think that energy is something we all continue to need and need more of. And I don't think anybody can ever get too much of it. So just some healthy habits that you can actually take, some habits you may currently have that you don't realize are zapping you of energy, and just switch them a little bit to help give yourself some more energy. So I will post a link to that down below as well. But as always, an amazing, amazing new person that I wanted to introduce you guys to. So thank you so much, Amy, for sharing your experience and your expertise with us, and love what you're doing to help women live well.
Well, thank you, Lisa. I really enjoyed speaking with you today and being here with your listeners.
All right. Well, thanks everyone for joining us. Make sure you tune in next week. And this is not information we want to keep to ourselves. I'm excited to go get that video because I'm looking for ways that I can, you know, add this into my day. And I'm sure you are, and as are people that are around you. So it could be coworkers, it could be family members, just someone that's in your life that could really benefit from this. Please share this with them, because the more women we can help live better, the better we can live out what we're called to do. So thanks everyone. Look forward to seeing you soon.
Thank you.
Let me turn it off. There we go. Okay.